In this episode of the Grinding Chronicles, we're going to look at the common bond systems used for superabrasive grinding wheels. Your bond is basically the glue that holds the materials in your grinding wheel together, and it impacts the wheel's performance. Selecting the right bond for your application is important for your process efficiency and workpiece quality. But grinding with the wrong bond can lead to burning, poor stock removal, or complete failure.
Welcome to the Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Engineering Manager, who we call the Wheel Wizard, also known as Jeff Wirth.
Hi, I'm Jeff Wirth, Engineering Manager at CDT. In this video, we're going to look at the four most common bond systems for super abrasive grinding: resin, metal, vitrified, and electroplated. You'll learn what each bond type is made of, how it is made, and how the physical properties align with certain applications. First, we have resin, which is a plastic-based compound used in phenolics or polyamides. Then we have metal, which can be a combination of metals such as bronze, copper, and iron, and is sometimes alloyed with precious metals such as silver. Vitrified is a glass or ceramic bond. Electroplated or plated is a single layer abrasive held by a nickel-based metal bond. At CDT, the manufacturing process for resin, metal, and hybrid bonds are essentially the same. The process begins with a formulation or recipe which is tailored to each of our customers' applications. These formulations include the bond material, abrasive fillers that are used to fine-tune the structure and grinding performance. The dry powder is mixed together in special tumblers and sent to the molding process, where it is carefully and uniformly poured and packed into the mold cavity. From there, the mold goes to hot pressing, where the mold temperature and pressure is closely controlled to produce the desired density grinding wheel. Finally, the wheel goes to finishing, where we machine and grind it to the desired size and geometry. For vitrified wheels, the process is similar. We begin with the formulation and mixing just as we do for resin and metal bonds. But with vitrified bonds, we go to a cold press and a sintering, or baking process, where the glass or the ceramic is fused together to create a hard, porous, vitrified bond. From there, the wheels go to finishing just like the others. Plating grinding wheels go through an entirely different process. First, the desired wheel size and geometry is machined onto a steel core or blank. The wheel core goes to masking, where the non-plated surfaces of the wheel are masked, which prevents plating of those areas during the plating process. Then it is placed into a bath with a nickel-based solution and the appropriate abrasive. In this process, a positive charge is placed on one side and a negative charge on the other, which deposits nickel plating onto the wheel core, causing a single layer of abrasive to stick. Once tacked, excessive abrasive is removed from the plating process and is continued until the single layer of abrasive is encapsulated to the desired level, usually 50 to 100% depending on the application. The plating process mimics the core geometry, so this process is ideal where complex forms are desired and minimum finishing is required, as they are already near net shape. Now that you understand how each of the bond types are made, let's talk about the physical properties and ideal applications. Resin is a relatively tough, durable, fully dense, and easy to use bond type. As the most versatile of all bonds, it can work with nearly any material, especially when fillers like copper and silicon carbide are added to enhance performance. Metal is the hardest, toughest, and most difficult bond system to use. While it grinds slower than other bonds, metal is the longest lasting. It is also the best bond type for highly abrasive materials like glass and ceramic. Vitrified bonds are porous products which significantly lowers the grinding force. This allows you to increase the grinding speed, making vitrified products ideal for high production applications. They offer moderate to high material removal rates and high tolerance form accuracy, as they can be profiled or formed in a process using rotary dressers. Plated products offer the highest material removal rates and fastest grinding speeds. They feature a single layer of abrasive that can be stripped and replated once the crystal is dull. Electroplated products are best for complex geometry and low to medium production applications. There are a lot of options for grinding with these bond systems. If you want to learn more about which bond type works best in your application, email one of our application engineers at the Grinding Chronicles at cdtusa.net.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tool.